Hey guys! So before we really jump into the topics for today's video, I wanted to mention that this video is kind of split into two separate parts. There's the beginning part of the video in which I create a collage slash mood board type of thing, and the second half in which I actually do a digital illustration based on the mood board. So with that in mind, let's get into it. The first thing I want to kind of mention about the concept behind these projects specifically is that I'm at the very beginning phases of a project right now, and for me, these are always very exploratory phases. These types of ideas can apply to any project, a series of paintings, a book, etc., etc. But in my case, it's actually a graphic novel. Now, a graphic novel is something I've kind of had in mind for years. I actually tried to do something a few years back and nothing really came of it, but it's always been something kind of swirling around in my mind, and it's a very large step to take, and I think that's why it's been this long in the making. And even now, I find myself being pretty non-committed, and this is something I did intentionally. I've been kind of talking about it over on Instagram, both in the actual captions of some of my recent posts, as well as in my stories, and I've been using the phrase poking at the idea of a graphic novel. Since something like a graphic novel is such a large undertaking, I don't want to just dive in and end up drowning. I kind of want to learn how to swim before I jump in the deep end. As such, I've been doing little doodles and concept sketches and illustrations based on the general mood that I am aiming for with this graphic novel. I have a very specific feeling in mind, and in order to kind of portray that to other people, the first thing I did was actually make a mood board. Now, if you don't know what a mood board is, it's fairly straightforward. It's used a lot in fashion design and interior design. And basically what I wanted to do was define a general vibe slash look that I was going for, and I wanted to create it in a way so that when other people looked at it, they would feel the same things that I felt when I imagined this world. To a certain extent, it was also so I could get it out of my head. Sometimes when I'm working on projects or different ideas, I get very stuck inside my own head, and all of the ideas and concepts all swirl together, and it gets very overwhelming. And so putting that out into the world in the form of something like a mood board, even, is very helpful for me personally. I think the word closest to what I really want to do is something like a cyberpunk. I like having a kind of apocalyptic feel, specifically with neon lighting and a dark slash gritty vibe. But I think this is a very good example of why it's helpful to create things like mood boards and illustrations is because hopefully upon looking at the finished mood board and my finished illustration, you'll understand, even if I can't put it into words very concisely. In a kind of similar vein to the mood board itself, I've also been using Pinterest to collect inspiration. I'm going to link to this particular story inspiration board in the description. The photos that I actually used for this mood board, I printed off of that Pinterest board, so if you're looking for them directly, you can find them there. And for me, Pinterest is good because it kind of gets the ideas flowing, at least as far as visuals are concerned. I can also use it for reference later on if that's necessary or desired. The only negative for me with Pinterest is that, like most websites, if you're not careful, it can be a little bit of a time trap. And so what I will end up doing is actually setting time limits for myself, where I'll tell myself that I can only be on for 20 minutes, and then that's it, I'm done. And for the most part, that has helped substantially. Then, after all of that kind of inspiration and mood board stuff was done, I actually buckled down and did an illustration. Again, I was really trying to use that vibe that I portrayed in the mood board itself. It's more of a feeling than it is a visual, even though the visual obviously plays into the feeling. And so I did some thumbnails and came up with something that genuinely made me happy and made me feel like, yes, this is my vision for this project. Now, when it came to the actual execution of this piece, color also played a very big role in portraying the mood that I was looking for. I used a lot of dark, desaturated colors since that's really what came to mind when I was trying to explain the mood that I was going for. However, the neon lighting was also very important to me as one of the elements that really defined the atmosphere of the world, and so I knew that I wanted to incorporate that as well. Now, speaking of color, I'm just going to go off on a little bit of a tangent. If you guys have been following me for a while, you might have heard me talk about my Skillshare classes, and I have recently uploaded a new class. I will leave a link to it in the description of this video, but essentially it's about color theory and learning how to use color in a more experimental, hands-on way as opposed to through technicalities, because though there is value in knowing things like terminology and how a color wheel works, I find that for me, I learn best when I'm experimenting and figuring things out for myself. So if you're interested in that, please check it out. Now, moving back to this specific project, this is actually very important to me. Because essentially, it's the epitome of what I do, or what I want to do. I tell stories. I always have. I've been writing since I was 13 years old. And when I say writing since I was 13 years old, I mean full-blown novels that were 50,000 words or longer. Before that, I was writing short story fun stuff that a lot of kids do. Art is also very important to me. Art is something that has always been a part of me. And so combining the two, combining illustration and storytelling, seems like a natural progression of my skills. It seems like a natural place for me to sort of settle. Now, I try to do this through my illustrations regardless, whether or not it's in the context of a comic book slash graphic novel. If I can portray how I'm feeling or some sort of message that I'm trying to send through an illustration, that's combining things that I love. And so I feel like something like a comic book or a graphic novel is just a step further than art pieces that tell stories in their own right. Now, since the filming of these two parts, I've actually done more concept sketches and drawings exploring this particular piece of the universe that I write in. At this time, it's a very interesting slice to me, conceptually. I like the vibe of it, I like the way that it looks in my head, and so spending some time expanding on it and playing with it has been very fun. And to me, it feels like the more I explore this part of the world and the more that I add to it and do more drawings and more concepts, the greater that desire to explore it becomes. Now, I'm not going to be recording every single instance of me working on these concept sketches because if things go according to plan, I will be doing quite a bit of it. However, I will be sharing stuff over on Instagram still, and I do plan on updating my actual website with things from this portion of the universe. There is a page titled Exploring Cyberpunk, and I only have a couple of things on there right now, but I'm interested to see how that continues to grow in the future, and I hope you guys enjoy coming along on this journey with me. So I hope that this was kind of interesting to you, that you got something out of my little ramble about mood boards and experimentation and things of that nature. Thank you all so much for watching. You can subscribe if you want, and I will see you guys next time. Bye.